problem with marijuana grows has eclipsed that of methamphetamine labs.
This is the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department SWAT team.
The Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department has seen an increase of 151% marijuana grows.
You need to do it right now.
Hello, I'm Captain Richard Collins. I'm the Bureau Commander for the Vice Narcotics Bureau of the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department. This is what is an ever-increasing problem that we've got in Southern Nevada is what we're calling grow houses. People need to know that it's not just some guy next door growing a plant in his window. It's much bigger than that. Then the next conception they have is that, well, if somebody's growing marijuana in a house, it's going to look something like the buildings we got behind me. I mean, you look around this neighborhood, you can see graffiti. These are old buildings that have been pretty much condemned. And people think, well, that's where they grow marijuana. Well, that's the biggest fallacy we have. The cultivators are people that are very well organized. They will come into a neighborhood. We're talking an upscale neighborhood. You know, you'll see kids playing, you'll see fancy cars. Most people want to have a good lifestyle, and that's where they move into. In today's economy, there's a lot of houses for rent. There's a lot of them that are being foreclosed on. The average individual who owns a house and they can't sell it and they try to rent it, they think they're supplementing their income. They think they're doing good. The people who are renting from them are probably paying them top dollar and they're getting what they think is a good deal until they find out what they do. What they actually do, they will have at least one point of entry, the front door, where if somebody walks by and the door was open, it looks like a normal house. Well, that's where the normality ends. As soon as you get around the corner, or if it's a multi-story, you get upstairs, there is no furniture, there are no pictures, there's nothing hanging on the wall. These individuals will chop holes in the wall, put air conditioning ducting through the walls, through the ceilings, through the floors, and then they have to have a big filtration system to take the smell and some of the particles out of the air. You will see that the windows are covered over with some type of tinfoil or covering. You'll see condensation on the windows. It's a hydroponics garden is what it is, and they can grow anywhere from 10 to 200 plants in an average 2,500 square foot house. These are on elevated beds. They use chemicals. They have a water filtration system that goes over and over again. There's a possibility that the water, if it stays on because they're not tended 24 hours a day, could cause major water damage. In that water, there's pesticides, herbicides, other chemicals which are hazardous to human health if they were come into contact with or if they were ingested. If there's some type of leak and it runs out into the foundation, the backyard, or down the street, it's a hazardous waste material. They also have to have a vast amount of electricity to put light on these plants. The mechanics of that is that they overload the electrical system. The electrical system can start fires. And back to the people who are renting this house out, they think they're doing good, but the cleanup alone, like I said, we spent $150,000 last year just on cleanup. If an individual goes in after we've gone in and condemned a house, and I use the word condemn very heavily because that's what we do, in order to get it, you either have to rebuild it or get a certified cleanup company to come in and clean out all the black mold, which is an offshoot of the warm, moist temperature with the light and the water that's in there. We're in a nice neighborhood somewhere in Las Vegas, and it can happen anywhere throughout Las Vegas Valley, Henderson, North Las Vegas, Summerlin, you name it, it's there. Some of the things we need to watch out for. If you have a house where there's nobody there, but sometime during the middle of the night, vehicles come and go, you hear strange noises, you see somebody coming with a load of lumber, but they're not there in the daytime. And again, like I said about the windows having condensation or being covered, that's to hide it from you, the citizen. The smell, when you combine this with the hours of the day, the rented house or the vacant house, the ones in foreclosure, the strange people coming and going, the strange hours are coming and going, the things that are just not normal, that's when we want you to call us. We will be there. You won't see us. We work undercover. Call us, Metro Narcotics, 828-3461, and we will take that complaint. If you call us, you can remain anonymous if you want. You can tell us your name. However, we will send somebody out to check on it. It is a major hazard to your children, to your neighborhood, to fire safety, and to the cleanup, which is hazardous materials.